How does the WWC determine the characteristics that we use to assess baseline equivalence? Each review protocol states the characteristics for which studies must demonstrate equivalence between groups. Typically, it requires a pre-intervention measure of an academic outcome measure, or pretest, but sometimes it allows studies to use other characteristics that are highly associated with outcomes, such as teacher experience when the outcome is teacher retention. Sometimes the related characteristic must be another pretest from the same outcome domain, which is a set of related outcomes that the WWC grouped together. The requirements can vary substantially by protocol. For example, the beginning reading review protocol says studies must demonstrate baseline equivalence for the intervention and comparison groups in the analytic sample on one of the following pre-intervention characteristics: the same measure used as the outcome in the analysis tested at baseline. If a pre-intervention measure of the same outcome is not available, it may be acceptable to use a baseline measure of an outcome from any of the four outcome domains detailed in the eligible outcomes section of the protocol. For example, a study can use a pretest from an alphabetics domain to establish baseline equivalence for the reading fluency measure if a reading fluency pretest is unavailable. Review protocols usually require studies to demonstrate equivalence on a pretest of the outcome measure. However, sometimes a study examines an outcome for which a pretest measure is not possible. For example, a study examining the effect of an 8th grade intervention on students completing high school cannot measure high school completion at baseline. There's no possible way to measure high school completion before students enter high school. For these kinds of outcomes that have no pretest, the protocol lists one or more related characteristics on which the study must show equivalence. For example, studies of dropout prevention have no baseline measure of dropping out. Instead, the dropout prevention review protocol requires studies to show equivalence in several other areas: race or ethnicity, gender, one measure of disadvantage, such as the percentage receiving free or reduced price lunch, and one measure of school performance, such as achievement or attendance. A review protocol may require studies to consider other characteristics beyond pretest measures when they assess baseline equivalence. For example, the primary mathematics review protocol requires studies to note differences in certain characteristics they report. These include gender, English learner status, percentage of students receiving free or reduced price lunch, and others. In the case of the primary math review protocol, when baseline differences exceed 0.50 standard deviations, the review team leadership has discretion to indicate that the groups lack equivalence, even if pretest measures are equivalent. This requirement and the characteristics included vary by review protocol. Most protocols assess equivalence within outcome domains. This is the default approach if a protocol does not specify something different. If there is a baseline difference between the groups greater than 0.25 standard deviations for any required characteristic in a domain, then all the outcome measures in that domain would receive the Does Not Meet WWC Group Design Standards rating. A large baseline difference on a different but closely related pretest raises concerns that the comparison group differed significantly from the intervention group. In the example illustrated here, a study examined outcome measures in two domains: operations and patterns and classification. In the operations domain, none of the baseline differences are greater than 0.25 standard deviations. Analyses of outcome measures in this domain could meet WWC group design standards with reservations, provided they all include appropriate statistical adjustments for an acceptable pre-intervention measure of the outcome. In the patterns and classifications domain, one of the measures, classification test 1, has baseline differences greater than 0.25 standard deviations. Because of this, analyses of all outcome measures in the patterns and classification domain would receive the Does Not Meet WWC Group Design Standards rating. However, analyses in other domains can still meet standards. Importantly, equivalence may not work this way if some analyses use different analytic samples, meaning they included different units. If one of the analyses uses a different analytic sample, the non-equivalence of a baseline measure for that sample does not affect equivalence of other outcomes within the domain. So, if the analysis of classification test 1 measure used a different analytic sample than the other measures in the patterns and classification domain, then the other analyses in that domain could meet standards. Some protocols require studies to use a somewhat different approach to establish equivalence. A protocol might state that baseline equivalence in one domain affects baseline equivalence in other domains. This approach applies only to certain protocols, and they will specify it clearly. The beginning reading review protocol is one example. It states that if any outcome measure in any domain has a difference of 0.25 standard deviations or greater, then no outcome measures in any domains can meet WWC group design standards. This rule applies to this protocol since research has shown that many reading outcome measures are highly correlated, even those in different domains. This table of domains and measures illustrates an example of a study reviewed under the beginning reading review protocol. The outcome measures in the fluency domain are within an acceptable range. If the fluency domain were the only domain in the study, then it might have received the meets WWC group design standards with reservations rating. However, the comprehension 2 outcome measure has a baseline difference greater than 0.25 standard deviations. The protocol specifies that if any domain doesn't meet standards, then all domains do not meet standards. So neither the reading fluency nor the comprehension domains demonstrate equivalence. The study as a whole does not meet WWC group design standards. Note that the rules about analytic samples apply here as well. If the comprehension measures analysis used a different analytic sample from the reading fluency measures, then non-equivalence in the comprehension domain would not affect equivalence in the reading fluency domain. Some protocols take a different approach and demonstrate equivalence outcome by outcome instead of domain by domain. These protocols will state that studies must base equivalence on pretests of outcome measures. Under these protocols, non-equivalence of one measure has no bearing on the equivalence of other measures, even those in the same domain. For example, the secondary math review protocol assesses equivalence this way. The table shows an example with 3 outcome measures in the algebra domain. One of these, writing equations, does not demonstrate equivalence. Unlike the previous examples, the other measures in the domain are not affected. Although writing equations cannot meet WWC group design standards, the analyses of graphing and polynomials can. Other review protocols may have unique requirements. For example, the science review protocol allows equivalence to be demonstrated using a math, reading, or literacy measure if a science pretest isn't available. And the student behavior review protocol requires equivalence for a behavior measure, no matter what the other outcome measures are. Now, we'll talk about a few issues that frequently arise in studies related to baseline equivalence. For QEDs, study authors sometimes use propensity score matching techniques to select or weight the units in the intervention and comparison groups. The idea is to use individuals' baseline characteristics to predict how likely a given individual is to have received the intervention. That estimated probability of being in the intervention group is called a propensity score. The authors then try to match individuals based on their propensity scores in forming the intervention and comparison groups, so that the groups are similar at the start of the intervention. The propensity score often serves as a summary of the baseline characteristics of individuals. However, studies cannot use the propensity score to demonstrate equivalence. This is true even if the study used all the required baseline characteristics to estimate the propensity score. Studies must demonstrate equivalence using the actual characteristics listed in the review protocol, one at a time. Matching on propensity scores doesn't guarantee that groups would be equivalent on other individual measures. For example, groups may look equivalent or similar based on the propensity score, but differences in pre-intervention test scores could still exist. Studies have to use the measures designated in the protocol to demonstrate equivalence. some study authors impute baseline data in their analyses. Recall from the attrition module, which is module 2, that imputing data means replacing the unobserved data in some way. The WWC has determined that only certain approaches are acceptable for imputing baseline data, and the WWC Standards Handbook describes these approaches. If a study used an approach the WWC does not consider acceptable to impute any data in the analytic sample, the study does not meet WWC group design standards. The WWC has a special set of standards for studies with missing or imputed data for baseline measures that are required for demonstrating equivalence. The WWC Standards Handbook describes these standards. However, data imputed for baseline measures that are not required for demonstrating equivalence, such as gender under many review protocols, do not affect the rating, as long as the study used an acceptable approach to perform the imputation.